I am the poet of Harlem. We're gonna dedicate, this is part of the O'Leary video series, inspired by an educator, Washington DC, from Cardozo High School, Mr. O'Leary. We're at the site of the Mill Street Synagogue, first Jewish synagogue in North America. It was on this site on April 8th, 1730. The Mill Street Synagogue was consecrated and opened its doors for worship. Later led by Rabbi Gershom Mendez Sasis. This synagogue was the home of Congregation Sherith Israel. Congregation Sherith Israel was formed with the arrival of Asher Levy and his congregation of 22 Jewish men, women, and children at the Bowling Green in Lower Manhattan in September 1654, near this site. They were the first observant Jews ever in North America. This Mill Street Synagogue continued as an active Jewish synagogue until 1817. Sponsored by Lower Manhattan Historical Association, Bowling Green Association. Gift of Reckler Philanthropy, September 2019. Okay, you have to excuse me, this area is very busy. I wanted to not have other people's conversations. This is on Mill Street, downtown Manhattan, in the Wall Street area. Those who are familiar with New York City will remember the Delmonico's restaurant that was at Beaver and William Street. That restaurant, very famous in the olden days, is closed, but that plaque for the synagogue is down the street from there, walking west. Okay, and here's a plaque or street naming for, okay, let's see, can we get it? Synagogue plaque is on South William Street, Mill Street Synagogue, Texas Way. I don't know if I'm pronouncing those names correctly, but I'm doing the best I can. All praise is due to Allah. There's the Delmonico restaurant, very famous in the old days. I'm trying not to get people into this video, but I just want to show you how to get to that plaque for the synagogue. And I mentioned on the video about the picture, A Great Day in Harlem, that I made a montage collage the day I was present at that photo, great photo for Broadway workers, Broadway actors, singers, dancers, performers, every black Broadway, everything involved with Broadway. That photograph was for those people. And it was inspired by a photograph taken on 11617 East 126th Street in Harlem. There it is, Delmonico's, the very famous restaurant. It was an equivalent to, I believe, Oscars at the Waldorf. Okay. There it is, Delmonico's. And it's at Beaver and William Street. And you would go left of Delmonico's, that historic site there. You would go left of that building and go left of that building, stay on that street, and the plaque will be on the right hand side. That's Mill Street. And that was the site of synagogue, first synagogue. But what I wanted to say is, I am thinking of the montage that I had on Broadway when Mr. Chapman Roberts organized the photograph for Black Broadway, inspired by the jazz photo from August 12, 1958, photograph taken by Art King. Well, anyway, the little boy who I dedicated, little Jewish kid who I dedicated a collage to, was named Leiby Kletzky. That's the way I heard it pronounced. According to one of the sites on the internet, he was born Yehuda Kletzky. Leiby Kletzky, he was kidnapped, abducted, and killed by someone in a Borough Park area. It was a mentally disturbed individual. That was a very serious moment for me. I made, as I mentioned on the other video, a montage to honor Leiby Kletzky. I just wanted to make sure that little boy's name was part of the series, because I was present at the historic Broadway photo, and I started a video from the Great Day in Harlem video, and I had his montage that I made at that Great Day on Broadway video. I just wanted people to know who that little boy was. And let me see, I'm gonna walk up here to Wall Street. This is the bank, by the way. This is the bank, the Spike Lee Inside Man. They use this place as a bank, exchange place. This is Hanover and Exchange. There it is right here. This is the building. I was told it was Citibank in the old days. That's what I was told. But let me see. This is where that film was shot for Inside Man. As you know, there it is. Exchange Place. This is the building. 20 Exchange Place. It was used for the film Inside Man. It was about a very wealthy, powerful businessman who made great wealth, unspeakable, incomprehensible wealth during business, or during World War II, doing business with the Nazis. Let me see if this is correct. This says Brown Brothers Harriman and Company. Three handles. This is across from 20 Exchange Place, the bank owned by a powerful businessman who did business with the Nazis during the Holocaust. It's ironic, or well, surprisingly, I did not know it. It's across from Brown Brothers Harriman. That name came up in those days, doing business with the Nazis during World War II. That name came up. And some powerful people were involved with that. I don't know if that's where the story came from. Here we are on Wall Street. And I hope you remember in your prayers, Leiby Kletzky, the little 8-year-old boy who lost his life. I believe he was returning home from school. But I just wanted everyone to remember him. There's a memorial page that was created by his parents for him. His name is Leiby Kletzky. If you Google 9-year-old boy, Jewish kid, abducted, Borough Park, Brooklyn, B-O-R-O, Borough Park, Brooklyn, D his name and information would appear. And this is Wall Street, very powerful street indeed. But I just thought that was very unusual. 20 Exchange Place, I was informed, was a headquarters or a branch of Citibank. And that film was shot in the Citibank section. It's closed now. There is a history, I believe it's by a story or a book by General Smedley Butler. And this story talks about businessmen who sent the military, American military at that time, into Haiti to take gold from a vault belonging to the people of Haiti. And the gold was returned to the United States and put in the vault at Citibank. But it was not called Citibank in those days. It went by another name. And Haiti is called the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. Haiti was the land liberated by Toussaint Louverture. And if you ever go to Philadelphia, you will come across a history at Six and Market associating people of African ancestry with the American Revolution and what went down during that time. What part did we play? Toussaint Louverture's story is there, and two of his ministers are shown there on one of the kiosks doing business with two ministers from Toussaint's country, Haiti, doing business with the president of that time. I believe it was John Adams. And that caption for that story, or that picture or painting, it says this was the first time that someone, or an American president, or did business with someone, a nation, government, from people of African ancestry until, I believe, the 1950s, when African nations began to get their independence, which was after the war, World War II. Okay, we're going to end this video here. This is part of the O'Leary series. And continue to pray for the soul and the righteous life of that little 8-year-old boy, Leiby Kletzky. I just wanted to mention his name because I mentioned the story behind that collage. I just didn't mention his name as I look back. All of this is done extemporaneously. I have no notes with me. I'm going by memory the best I could and best I can. And once again, I would like to thank the public school teachers in Washington, D.C. I began in West School, and my true learning began with Mrs. Ruth Spiegelberg from the fourth grade at West Elementary on 14th and Farragut Street, Northwest. This is part of the O'Leary series. And something interesting, since we were talking about Judaic studies or Jewish history, Mr. O'Leary taught at Cardozo High School, named for Francis Cardozo. Francis Cardozo is a nephew, maybe a great-great nephew, of Benjamin Cardozo, the Supreme Court Justice. I just wanted to mention that. And Benjamin Cardozo was Jewish, and Francis Cardozo was black, but his family are from the Jewish Cardozo family. Okay, God bless you all. Thank you.